Next tonight, a young woman from Devizes has been stung into action by a dramatic drop in the number of bees.
The 18-year-old has joined forces with Friends and Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice, to let people know about the challenges bees face and how we can help them.
My name's Freya Bygott, I'm 18 years old and I'm from Devizes in Wiltshire. Fixers is helping me and my friends tell others about the dramatic decline in the bee population and what they can do about it. Today we've been finding out some more about how bees live.
And there is a baby bee about to be born. Do you see it?
Yeah.
As we talk, here it comes.
It's coming.
It's eating its way out. So that was an egg 21 days ago today.
Bees are important because they pollinate about 75% of crops, and so our food sources, they wouldn't be there if we didn't have bees, and they're so important as part of the natural cycle.
Robert, our campaign is all about saving the bees from their decline in population. What kind of problems are they facing?
In London, where I used to keep bees, I had every garden you could imagine, and I used to get about 150 pounds of honey per colony in London, while in the country down here now, I'm lucky if I get 30 pounds of honey. Now, if you look round here, you'll see that there's acres of land that's wheat or corn or something, and there's not a lot of forage for the bees. So the great thing would be for beekeepers to encourage farmers to plant lots of lovely strips of wild flowers.
We found out there are lots of things we can all do to help bees thrive, like planting the right plants in your garden.
Well, generally speaking, you're looking for a simple open flower where a bee can land easily, especially some of the larger bees. Different sized bees like different sized flowers. Or you might be looking at things that are tubular. So over there, we've got some foxgloves. Over there are single dahlias, which are also brilliant for bees. So single, straightforward, simple flowers with plenty of nectar, plenty of pollen, easily accessible.
Fixers has helped us design some booklets to get our message across. At the start, it covers about, you know, why is this an issue that you should be interested in? And then it tells you more about the issue in detail and how you can be part of the solution. Things like what plants to buy and what pesticides to avoid in your own garden. So it's just about telling people how they can be involved. And it's something that you can address as an individual, and you don't have to be anyone special.
And of course, if you want to go one step further and really have bees in your garden, you could always have something like this bumbularium.
In today's world, where we can live so much through our phones and online, I think people often just forget about the actual physical world we're living in and nature that surrounds us. And so I think it's just good to draw people's attention and remind them that actually we are still part of a community out there, and it's actually really important that as a human living here, you know, you've got to take your responsibility.
Well, that's it. I need a bumbularium.
I know. What's not to like about a bumbularium?
Now, you were saying though, you're doing your bit for bees.
Well, leaving a bit of the garden kind of unmown this year, so the kind of the weeds start
not
to flower
being
and
lazy.
Stuff.
No, not at all.
But it has worked. There are definitely bees enjoying it.
Well, if you want to see more about this story and Fixers, then you can go to fixers.org.uk.